Here we are asked to consider 3x plus 4y equals 8. Part A asks us to write the equation in slope-intercept form. So slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b. So our goal is to get the y variable isolated. So let's go ahead and do that. So I want to get the y variable isolated. So first thing, we have to subtract 3x, get rid of this term. Whatever we do to one side, we do to the other side. It does not matter which one of these goes first, so you could put it as 8 minus 3x here. But I'm going to go ahead and put the negative 3x first, and then this is a positive 8, so plus 8. And the reason why I do that is because the x term is usually right after the equal sign, so... and the constant goes last, so I'm going to keep it consistent with that. So then, to leave the y by itself, since this 4 is being multiplied as the coefficient of the y, we undo it by dividing, because 4 divided by 4 is 1y. So whatever we do to one side, we have to do to the other side. So we're dividing everything by 4. So 4 cannot go into 3 evenly, so we're going to leave it in simplified, which it already is, so negative 3/4. And then 8 divided by 4 is 2, positive 2. Okay, so it asks write the equation in slope-intercept form, which we just did. And then it asks us also to identify the slope. So the slope is just the number in front of the x. So we would write negative 3/4 here. So it asks us to do two things. All right, next, part B says to graph the lines on the grid. Okay, so to graph, we're going to take our y-intercept right here, this positive 2. And graph it. And then our slope is negative 3/4, so we're going to go down and to the right. So we're going to go down 3, so 1, 2, 3, and then over 4. And that's where our point will be. Then we're going to go down 3, so 1, 2, 3, and then over 4. And that's where our next point is going to be. Now, that's the same thing as if we go the opposite. So instead of down 3, if we go up 3, but this time we go left. So we're going to go up 3 and left 4. Up 3 and left 4. And then we have our line. Part C asks us to write the slope-intercept form, so y equals mx plus b, of a line that has a y-intercept of negative 3, okay, so y equals mx plus b. It said that the y-intercept is negative 3. So that means our b here, they tell us, is negative 3. And it has to be perpendicular to the line we just graphed. So we know that for two lines to be perpendicular, you have to have one line go up. So if the line goes up, then the one that's perpendicular to it has to go down so that they make the right angle. So to have slopes being two lines to be perpendicular, the slopes of the two lines, one has to be negative, one has to be positive. So that's the first thing we have to do. So if we look back here, this one had a slope that was negative. That means this one's going to have a slope that is positive. And then the other thing that we learned is that they are negative reciprocals. So one's negative, the other one's positive, and they're reciprocals. So we're going to go ahead and switch the 3 and the 4. So the slope here is going to be positive 4/3. So our slope is positive 4/3. So that would be our equation. All right, part D says to graph this with our other graph, our other line, and make sure that they are indeed perpendicular. So I'm going to go ahead and start here at negative 3 on the y-axis. And then our slope is positive, so I'm going to go up and right. So up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to go over 3, so right here. Okay, and then from there, I'm going to go up 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then over 3, so right there. And then I connect my points, and then I verify that this does indeed make 4 right angles, so they are perpendicular.